The most recent Mordor patch has introduced new perks to the game. Two of these additions are particularly noteworthy, namely the Dwarf and Tank perk. Both are heavily used right now, mainly because of their roleplay potential. In this video, we will have a deeper look at their advantages and disadvantages, and see if these perks are somehow viable beyond their roleplay potential. Let's start with the Dwarf perk. The Dwarf perk comes with the following drawbacks. Dwarfs are fragile and take increased damage. To be precise, 50% more damage than without the perk. Speaking in armor tiers, 50% is often somewhere between 1 and 2 full armor tiers difference, which is a lot. As a consequence, dwarfs can get 2-shot by most weapons, even in full tier 3 armor. Dwarfs are short-legged and therefore slow. Here you can see a movement speed comparison between a tier 3 armored dwarf and a regular tier 3 guy. As you can see, they are worlds apart. Even the difference between full tier 2 dwarf and full tier 3 regular is still quite substantial. A full tier 1 dwarf can keep the gap a bit closer, but is still slower. And not even a naked dwarf can beat out a full tier 3 regular guy in this race. Another disadvantage of the dwarf perk is the lower weapon range. Weapon length and equipment is scaled down, even though to a lesser degree than the player model. It costs 3 points to equip the Dwarf perk, which is obviously a disadvantage too. This list of severe drawbacks comes together with a few advantages. The main advantage of the Dwarf perk is the downsized player model. Small things are harder to hit than big things, which is especially true for archers and other projectiles. The Pavies shield, even though a little bit smaller than the normal version, almost covers the whole player model and can be used as a mobile guard. A consequence of the low height of dwarves is that it is somehow harder to hit them with overheads, since you can't really foot drag them that easily. But it is also noteworthy that the head hitbox makes a bigger percentage of the total player model, which makes high damage head hits more common. Due to the fact that dwarf attacks come out from a lower height, underhand drag axle mix-ups are somewhat more viable. I don't think they are insane or anything, but something that can be used as a surprise. So beside roleplay aspects, there is not much reason to pick the dwarf perk. In my opinion, the best pup role for it is to play as a dwarf archer with a ranged weapon and the pavies. Slow movement speed, lower range and increased vulnerability are just too big of a handicap in melee combat that can't be compensated with a smaller hitbox. Let's have a look at the tank perk. The difference in size between a tank and a regular player model is not as big as the difference between a dwarf and the regular player model. The biggest drawback of the tank perk is their movement speed debuff. Tanks walk and sprint at a fixed movement speed, no matter what armor they have equipped. Here is a movement speed comparison between a tank and a regular heavy armor guy. The foot speed is comparable to that of a fully armored dwarf. Someone in light armor will have the same backpedal speed as the forward sprint speed of a tank on the first few meters, which makes it almost impossible to get close. So dueling as a tank, especially with short weapons, is not really an option against someone in light armor. Another downside of the tank perk is the more restrictive turn caps. This means that the camera can't be moved as fast during a swing as without the perk, and thus makes drags way less threatening. The tank perk is with 6 points painfully expensive, since you basically need to wear max armor with it. Wearing less than tier 3 armor won't make you any faster and will reduce your damage reduction to a point where it would be more effective to just take more armor instead of the perk. Full tier 3 tank only leaves 18 points left for weapon, equipment and other perks, which prevents you from equipping one of the bigger weapons. The tank perk slows down HP regen. It also makes it so the Bloodlust perk only heals you for 50 instead of 100 HP. The main selling point of the tank perk is its increased protection against incoming ranged and melee attacks. The exact reduction value is 29%. This allows tanks to take one or two more hits before going down. Tank weapons also have slightly more range. The difference is very minor though. Even though Bloodlust is nerfed for the tank perk, I think a Bloodlust build is the way to go in pubs if you really want to play as a tank. My recommended build is 333, Bloodlust, friendly, tank, with a short sword and a bandage, and picking up a big weapon somewhere on the battlefield. Standing in the middle of a teamfight, drawing attention and healing back up with Bloodlust is where the tank feels at its strongest. Preferably, you want to pick up long-range weapons with good stab damage, since your ability to land hits with drags is very limited due to the restricted turn cap and the low movement speed. Another decent pick for the tank perk could be in 3v3 ranked games or any other scrimmage game where you are the lowest rank in your team and you need to survive as long as possible. Here could a tank build, optionally with kite shield, work well, since staying alive longer for that one extra hit can make all the difference for the team. As a bottom line, I think it's fair to say that the tank perk can be viable in some rare cases. The dwarf perk, on the other hand, is comparable to the peasant perk, where you pick it to play the game willingly at a disadvantage. However, killing someone in a duel yard as an old grumpy dwarf with a pickaxe while yelling high-pitched voice lines can be hilarious. I do agree with the developer's decision to make these perks somewhat underpowered, which ensures that they are not completely overused, but still interesting content to play around with. Anyway guys, that's my take on the dwarf and tank perk. Please leave a comment and a like if you enjoyed this video and consider subscribing if you want to see more Mortar content in the future. As always, thank you all for watching and see you soon.